With doubtnit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnit app today.
The question says a solid metallic right circular cone of height 6.75 cm and radius of the base 12 cm is melted and two solid spheres formed from it. If the volume of one of the sphere is 8 times that of the other, find the radius of the smaller sphere. So first of all, I will write all those things that are given to us. So basically there's a cone here. So you can say there is a cone. So say this was the cone, a solid cone. So this was the cone and it is being converted into two spheres. So one is smaller and the other one is bigger. Now what we are given is that we are given the dimensions of this cone. So this is given, that is height of cone 6.75 centimeters, radius of cone is equals to 12 centimeters, and it is said that it is melted. So basically now if you and made into two solid spheres which are formed, one is bigger and one is larger. Now it is said that when you melt this, when you solve this, the volume of this cone, whatever the solid or whatever the material, the volume of the material used to make this cone will be equal to the volume of these two spheres, material used to make this sphere, because no other material has been added, no other material has been destroyed and taken out or added here. So therefore, whatever the volume of this cone is, solid metal cone is, that will be the sum of these two spheres. So basically, what we can say is that volume of cone is equals to volume of both spheres. This is what we have. Now if we calculate the volume of cone, we'll get the volume of both the sum of, we'll get the total volume of the spheres. So for doing this now, for, and also it is given that if the volume of one of the sphere is 8 times that of the other, that is, say this is S1, the bigger sphere, and this is S2. So it says that volume of one of the sphere is 8 times that of the, that is S1, that is V of S1 is equals to 8 times V of S2. We can write it where this V of S1 represents volume of S1 sphere. So what you can need, first we will find the volume of this cone and then we will use this formula to find the radius of the smaller sphere. So smaller sphere is S2. So what we can say is, so volume of cone is given by 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now 1 by 3, I will keep pi as it is. Now radius is given to us as 12 centimeters. So 12 into 12, since it is square, and height is 6.75. So I will remove the decimal by writing 100 under it. So this is what we have. Now when you multiply this by this, when we divide this by or multiply this by 25, this will come out to be 14. And this will come out to be 27. So this is what we have. Now what we have, now this 4 will divide this 3, and this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled out. So volume of sphere comes out to be 12 into 27 into pi. Now 12 into 27 is equals to, so volume of cone is equals to 12 into 27 is 324 pi centimeters cube. This is the volume of sphere. Now volume of, or we can write it as volume of S1 plus volume of S2 will be equal to 324 centimeters cube, because we know that it is using the same material, so it is melted and converted into some other shape, though the matter is not destroyed nor it has been added. So volume of S1, so now we know that volume of S1 is 8 times volume of S2. So what I am going to write is, this will be 8 V of S2 plus this is V of S2. So volume of S2, this is comes out to be 324 centimeters cube. So what we get is 9 V of S2 is equals to 324 centimeters cube. From here, what we get is that volume of second sphere, the sphere S2, is equals to 324 by 9. So when we divide it by 9, so 9, this will come out to be 9 3 is 27, so this is left is 5 4, so 9 3 is 36. So what we have is volume of sphere 2 is equals to 36 centimeter square. This is the volume of the sphere. Now what you do is, now volume of sphere, the formula of volume of sphere is, now volume of sphere S2 will be equal to 4 by 3 pi r2 cube, where 2 represents the second sphere, so pi r2 cube, and it is given to us as 36 centimeter square, sorry, 36 pi, sorry, I made a mistake here, this should be 36 pi, this should be 324 pi here also, so I will remove all this, so this should be 324 pi centimeter square. This also pi centimeters cube. So this will also pi centimeters cube. So what I get is that here also 36 pi centimeters cube. So now this is what we have. So 4 by 3 pi r2 cube. This is also cube, is equals to 36. So from here, this 4 into 9 is 36. And so what we are left is, and here it is pi, or I can write it as, I will resolve this. So this will become, this will come out something like this. So 4 by 3 pi r2 cube is equals to 36 pi. So I accept r2 cube, I will take everything on the right hand side, will be 36 pi into 3 by 4 pi. So 4 pi and pi gets cancelled out, 4 into 9 is 36. So what we get from here is that r2 cube is equals to 9 into 3, that is 27. So what we have, 27, now r2 cube, now 27 is basically cube of 3, so 3 cube. So what we get is, from by comparing this, we get r2 is equals to 3 centimeters. Now this r2 is nothing but the radius of the smaller sphere, and that's what we had to find. So therefore, this is our final answer.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.